Jesus.
Upon our
in the name of Jesus, receive your blessing. Don't do that, that is a jugular.
YouTube, what's going on? Trey back again, hit you with a video. Now this video comes out of Africa by way of Ghana, and thank you to my subscribers over there in the motherland who sent that video to me and basically said, Trey, check this out. And I was like, well, what could possibly be going on in Africa that I really need to know about? If it's always it's going to always be a preacher, or it's going to always be somebody getting caught cheating. It's one or the other. You go back through and check the videos, the catalog I got, the archives, most likely. But anyway, now when I went and checked this video out, it was a preacher and a pastor. You already know how I feel about these preachers and pastors. Not all of them. And let me make myself very, very clear today, because today is Friday. Some of you all ain't got no job, and some of you all ain't got ish to do. I didn't want to say the S word since I'm talking about preachers. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to be no hypocrite right now. We'll say that for another video, but not the hypocrite part, the cussing part. But anyway, now when I went to check this video out, I'm like, what is pastor going to do? Is he going to do like some of these other preachers do? Like, they had one story. I don't know if it was Kenya or Nigeria. It might have been Nigeria. But you had one pastor had all these women lined up on the beach. Yes, had them all lined up on the beach. Butt naked, yes, bucket naked, like Bernie Mac said off of Players Club. Had these women lined up, had them face down, and had their butt up. You feel me? But anyway, and you might say, well, damn, why did the pastor have these women face down, butt up on the beach? You know what I'm saying? About like 40 women, for as the eye could see, you didn't see nothing but buttocks everywhere. You know what I'm saying? Buttocks and camel toes. But anyway, so I'm like, well, what's the purpose of having these women on the beach like this? Come to find out, the pastor said he wanted to give them a special kiss in the places that God missed and blessed them. Yes, he wanted to give them a special kiss in the places that God missed. And you know where that place at, that cookie. But anyway, he said it was basically to help them and put the spirit of the Lord inside of these women. That's Nigeria. All these women lined up. So you had another preacher. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to say his name. Some of you all might already know his name. Last name Dollar. And you already know what the dollar means. It's all about that money, money. Cash rules everything around me. Kring it. Like Wu-Tang said, dollar, dollar bill, y'all. You know, and this guy wanted people to buy him a jet, his own congregation. I'm like, damn, don't you already have a jet? Don't you already have a plane? How about we just get you a helicopter? You feel me? But no, they wanted to raise $64, $65 million for a damn jet. And then you have other preachers who's coming out, they competing for the biggest church, some getting caught cheating, or like the one we had back in the day, you know, Jimmy Swagger, the one who got caught cheating twice. You know what I'm saying? You would think after the first time they caught you, he cried on TV, I have sinned. Oh, forgive me, I have sinned. You would have think he would have learned his lesson the first time. But no, not damn Jimmy. Jimmy went right back to the hotel, motel, Holiday Inn, and got it in, and next thing you know, he get exposed again. But anyway, so these preachers, what I'm trying to say, I said all that to say this, they would tell you anything. Your faith have to be intact. Now, I know some of you all, we taking baby steps and we all learning. Every day is a step-by-step process. But you should feel very strange, just like in this situation, back to the video, the main topic. But we have a Ghanaian pastor asks his church goers for $5 before they shake his hand. Like, you can't shake my hand if you ain't got five bones, five racks. And I'm not talking about 5,000. No, you got to have $5 in your pocket. You cannot touch the palms of my hand. And you might ask yourself, well, damn, why is he charging these people to touch him and to shake his hand? the first question you ought to ask is, why is the people in there? If anything, he ought to be paying them, right? But that goes to show you the way of the world and why the way is the way the world is today. You know what I'm saying? The world is lost. The people is lost. Everybody, like Whitney Houston said back in the day, everybody trying to find that hero. You know what I'm saying? People need someone to look up to. I understand that part right there. But at the same time, let me tell you something. You got to have common sense in this world. And I'm speaking all across the world. You feel what I'm saying? I got people everywhere listening to me. You already know what I'm going to say about one of them cities. I got them in Germany listening to me. And they probably even know what the hell I'm saying. I got them in Australia listening to me. Talking about, keep going, mate. I got them everywhere. I got them in Bangkok. Why are they doing the other thing? You know what I'm saying? Then I got them in Kashnakistan. Big shout out to Kashnakistan. All three of y'all in that little city. All y'all be holding it down for real. But at the same time, you know, I must tell you all, you know, You got to learn to know the Most High for yourself. Let me tell you something, because when you know him for yourself, and I'm not going to preach to y'all. I'm not going to be one of these hypocrite YouTube preachers or whatever the hell is. And I'm not sending no shouts out at nobody. So don't nobody be sending nobody no video. Yellowbone, Trey, know the ledge. He talking about you. No, I'm not. I'm not saying no name. But if the shoe wear it, by all God's mean, you can wear it. You know what I'm saying? But at the same time, you know, you have to have faith by yourself. You have to know the Lord for yourself, because once you know the Lord, and I'm not trying to preach like I said, but once you know the word and really how to stand upright, it's all about standing upright. All these construction, these titles that we done gave ourselves, bishops, cardinals, reverends, pastors, God don't care about none of that. God don't care about none of that. What he do care about for those who believe is this right here. Are you telling my people the truth? If you're going to claim to be a preacher, that's why you have to be careful. That's why their children get punished the worst. Because what? The sins of the father, the mother, whatever, shall be passed on to the children also. But I'm not going to preach now. So that what I'm saying is this. If you might not get caught up in your sin, but what you're doing and the people that you done led astray and you knowing that you're leading them astray, guess what? If you don't catch it, it's going to fall on your children. If it don't fall on them, it's going to fall on your grandchildren. That's what you call generational curses. But anyway, back to these hypocrites. You know what I'm saying? If any time you got to go to a institution, a church, because there ain't nothing but institutions, most of them. Now, you got some of them out there that really help the people. And big shout out to you all. I can count you all probably on one or two hands. You know, you have very few preachers who's sincere about helping the people, about telling the people the truth to the best of their ability. Because you have to understand, until the day we die, we still learning. None of us know it all. You feel what I'm saying? None of us know it all. So if you think you know it all, if you listen to somebody who claim they know it all, you need to question that man also. Because the smartest man would admit that he don't know nothing. You feel me? Let me repeat that. The smartest man would admit that he don't know nothing. Because nothing is as it seems. We all just in this room together, trying to find our way out, just like crabs in a barrel. Some of us gonna make it out. Some of us gonna get pulled back down. But I'm trying to be one of the ones that crawl out the barrel. You feel me? That's out this matrix that we live in. So what I'm saying is this right here. Do you see these preachers? They'll have you paying your light bill money, tell you God gonna bless you with the money. God already blessed you with the money. That's how you able to pay him. You talking about, well, I'll put back on my light bill because I don't want pastor saying nothing. See, when you feel like that and you have to sit up here and go between getting your lights cut off or food on your table or gas in your car to paying them, and they already pulling up in nice cars, and that's good if they do, but at the same time, how did they get that? They got it off the sweat of your back. But what they would tell you, a lot of them, is that I built this up, or I had this. If you didn't have this when you started preaching, that means the church gave it to you, right? I mean, simple. That's just like if you go to a job and you ain't even have a car. You work at the job 2 years, all of a sudden you able to get a house and a car. Who gave it you the house and the car? The job, of course. The same way with these preachers, but they'll have you so brainwashed. It's some of them, not all of them, because I know a few good of them. Like, I always got to say that, because I don't want nobody to think I'm trying to turn you all against preachers or the church. No, I'm not turning you all against the church. Number one, you're going to do what you want to do anyway, grown folks. I'm just here to pull your coattail, like the old folks say, and say, beware of these tactics that they use. Now, if you got to pay your preacher to shake his hand, that means you're not even worthy. You're not even his equal. He don't even look at you. He look at you as like a sheep. I guess that's why they call them sheep in the church, right? And do you all know what the job of a shepherd is? To lead the sheep to the slaughter. I mean, come on. Let's be real. That's why you don't have too many rams and bucks in the church, males in the church. You know what I'm saying? Because that man cannot sit there and tell no able-bodied thinking man what to do and how to act and stuff, how to treat this woman. You have some preachers who will actually try to counsel you on how you should live your life and your relationship, but at the same time, they sit up here and cheat, come out the hotel, motel, all times of night, but they'll get up in church and tell you and profess to be holier than thou and tell you that you living in sin and stuff when they got about 50 damn different women number in their cell phone and stuff and pictures, videos and everything. So, to my people who hear this, and also my peeps in Africa also, you have to question these people, because when I see Africa, they are taking on the same image that America had for us, this preacher, for us being outlandish. You remember the Benny Hinn's? Benny Hinn just wave his whole coattail around the crowd and the whole front row just fall back. Y'all seen the videos and stuff. I'll try to put a clip if I can find one. Or he'll go touch somebody like he's God himself. He'll barely just touch their head and they'll just jump back and start hollering. Or he'll do his hands like he ride you off a street fighter like this. Oh, you kid. And shoot fireballs out and make 10 people fall back like dominoes. So what I'm trying to tell you this, you have to stop being entertained by the theatrics. Stop being entertained with people who are performing these false miracles on you, because half of this stuff is scripted. A lot of these shows, you see people, the preacher be up there talking to demons and stuff. Number one, if you talking to a demon, how can a person still be in a right mind and stuff? Eyes ain't crossed back or nothing. No spit or nothing coming out their mouth. They just, anybody can make a stupid ass noise like that. I mean, come on. So when you see this stuff, don't think they casting out demons, because that's the same thing they did back in the day, even though that was real. But what I'm trying to say is this. You go all across YouTube in these videos. You see these so-called men of God who men of the cloth. I don't know what kind of cloth they talking about. They must be talking about cotton or satin. It's not the cloth that I'm thinking about. But anyway, they supposed to be stand-up men. But at the same time, they got more cun games than damn the cun games man themselves out there on the streets. You know what I'm saying? It's no difference than some of them. And if you don't pay that money, watch how they turn against you. Watch how they won't even say your name in church. You know what I'm saying? That's why most of these churches is nothing but a fellowship. You know what I'm saying? It's a club for the older people, most likely, because I don't see nobody getting saved in these churches hardly no more. You have very few churches. Some of you all might know them. You know what I'm saying? Some of you all might belong to a church that's really helping people, healing people, being there for the people, because we all need somebody to what? Lean on. You feel me? Let's just be for real. But at the same time, would you rather lean on the truth or would you rather lean on a lie? Because guess what? When it comes time for you to stand on something, lean on something, if it ain't the truth, it's going to fall, because it's not real. You know what I'm saying? So get with the real. You know what I'm saying? Like I say, out with the fake, in with the real. Find you something concrete that you can believe in. Stop paying these people $5 just to shake their hand. You could have took that $5 and put something in your belly or your child belly or something. All for you just to get up on a pastor grace. Pastor don't give a damn about you, most of them. You know what I'm saying? Because you ain't nothing but they meal ticket. You know, some going to like it, some going to love it. You know what I'm saying? I be getting emails and stuff from people all over the world, basically telling me, you know what I'm saying, they understand far as I'm saying about the pastor. But then, you know, you have some of them who so protective of their pastor, like they would take a bullet for their homie, like they would take a bullet for pastor. You know what I'm saying? You have to call it out. You got to call a spade a spade. Let me know what you all think about this video. But like I said, you know what I'm saying, the best thing that you could do, because we have to learn from somebody. That's how we learn to talk. You know what I'm saying? We didn't come out our mama's womb. We didn't come out of her speaking English. We didn't come out of her speaking Spanish, whatever language you speak. These are traits that we pick up, just like learning things. But at the same time, the truth resonates inside of you. You know what I'm saying? When you know God, you don't need nobody to come translate anything. You know what I'm saying? Because people, man, can only take you so high until it's got to be something, a divine intervention to take you a step further. And if you all don't understand that, you all don't understand English. So what I'm saying is this right here. You know what I'm saying? Get what you can get from these people. And at the same time, just like eating fish, like I said, you take what you can consume and spit out the bones. But, you know, you have to understand the type of things that you're dealing with, because you can also thinking that you helping yourself and you can add more curses to yourself. You feel me? Because some of these places you shouldn't even be in anyway. Because you ever went to church and you came out feeling mad? Ask yourself, why I'm feeling mad coming out of church? Because you round these unfamiliar spirits, if you know what I mean. But I'm not gonna preach. But I just want to let you all know that if you got to pay somebody to shake their hand, I don't care if you're in Mexico, I don't care if you're in America, I don't care if you're in Africa. You don't have to do that. You know what I'm saying? You go to church for what? To supposedly, allegedly, to get a relationship, a fellowship with God. You know what I'm saying? That's supposed to be your purpose for going. Whatever you want to call them, Allah, Jehovah, who cares? The point is, that's the reason why you go, to get closer to God, not to get closer to man and have to pay them a fee. Because you're basically telling them, you're basically paying them and also telling them in a way, look, we're going to keep supporting your lifestyle as long as you sit up here and feed us and make us feel entertained. And also, before I go, you know, some people just want to be entertained. Some people don't want to hear the truth. So you have to understand, you have some people going to church for the truth because they want to be saved, they fear God. You have some people who go just because it's a routine, it's a tradition. Then you have some people who just go just to keep up mess, to see what the Joneses, the Browns, the Jacksons, and the Smiths are doing. Anyway, let me know what you all think about this video. And if you like this video, subscribe to the channel. Definitely put a like down for the video. And also, beware of the people you listen to. I don't care if it's me or anybody else. Be careful of the people you listen to, because anybody coming to profess the Most High and they charge you, I mean, that should be simple right there. But I understand a lot of people ain't on that level. But anyway, you all have a blessed day. And like I say, keep your eyes open. I'm out.